Dyverso, they are rigid and elastic fluid solvers to simulate dynamic particle behavior. To set a rigid or elastic solver, select the Dyverso domain and choose the type of solver. In this case, the elastic one. We also have to indicate which geometry to fill with particles. Here, we choose the octopus geometry. Let's hide the geometry to see the particles in the viewport. In the relationship editor, connect Dyverso to the objects which will collide with it. Add a hub and connect the nodes to it. Add a gravity daemon too. In the simulation options, activate CUDA to take advantage of the GPU simulation, which is much faster than the CPU one. If we simulate the scene, we see how the particles collide with the cube, maintaining the shape of the geometry, but deform it like an elastic body. We can also configure how collision geometries interact with Dyverso's elastic particles by modifying their Dyverso interaction parameters. In this way, you obtain different fluid behaviors. Let's increase the fluid resolution. Once we increase the Dyverso resolution, the fluid behavior as an elastic is better and we have more particles to control the simulation. Wet maps can be used for simulations with rigid or elastic solvers. So let's check if the wet map option is active. And simulate the scene. See how the wet map is being generated when particles collide with geometry. Changing the wet map parameters creates different configurations for wet map behavior. For example, the aging parameter indicates the lifetime in seconds for that wet map. In addition to creating a dynamic simulation of Dyverso fluids, the particles can control the deformation of geometries to which they are somehow connected. So far, we see that the octopus mesh was used to create the elastic particles, but it does not interact with them. To make the mesh deform with Dyverso particles, add a daemon called Particle Skinner. It will deform the geometry depending on the particle simulation. If you simulate now, you can see how the octopus geometry is modified by the particle simulation. By modifying the Dyverso elastic fluid parameters, you can adjust how the particles' behavior affects the geometry controlled by these particles. So, these parameters affect the fluid simulation as well as the particle Skinner daemon. We can quickly simulate thousands of objects controlled by particles using Dyverso on GPU. Also, the Particle Skinner daemon works with the cache fluid speeding up the simulation. Even if you set the fluid to cache and activate the Particle Skinner daemon, the geometry will be affected by those particles. Thank you for watching and enjoy RealFlow!